Peter approached Jesus and asked him, "Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as 7 times? Jesus answered, "I say to you, not 7 times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him, owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down and did him homage and said, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full." Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When the servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, "Pay back what you owe." Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have pity on your fellow servant as I have pitied on you?" And then his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from the heart. In the Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
He was led away to be slaughtered like a sacrificial lamb. When he was led away to be slaughtered like a sacrificial lamb, when his torturers demanded that he extend his right arm so his right hand could be nailed to the cross, he said, "Not a word." When they asked him to extend his left arm so that his left hand could be nailed to the cross, he said, "Not a word." In silence, he allowed himself to be nailed to the cross in sacrifice for you and I. When he spoke from the cross, his first words to his Father was, "Forgive them, for they know not what they do." So often we pray to God for forgiveness for our foolishness, our selfishness, our sin. Do we not want complete removal of guilt and shame? What we want God to do for us in the sense of forgiveness, in the sense of peace and hope, we are challenged the 10th anniversary of 9/11, we are challenged to forgive like Jesus forgives us. In the 40 years I've been a priest, there are times I've heard people say to me, "No, I can't forgive. I can't let go." We must remember the parameters of the law of charity. God does not ask us to like everyone, but He asks us to love everyone. And in that expression of love, which certainly is not romantic, but in that expression of love, if at times we have difficulty in finding the words, the correct words to say, and we may not be able to say them to the individual we have some difficulty with, but we can pray to God and ask God to bless that individual in the ways that he or she may need most. If we allow ourselves through faith to say that prayer, eventually our own set of feelings will catch up and we will let go of that excess pain. Jesus does not ask us to turn ourselves inside out, but he does ask that we be open to his help to make us new. As St. Paul reminds us in the second reading, we are not here alone. We are not without this connection, this God connection, who will give us strength when we need it the most. Peace without God is very, very elusive. In part because there can be no peace without justice. Justice as defined by God. God's justice is not retribution, revenge, or anything along that line. We're constantly asked to reaffirm what motivates us, what's in our gospel DNA. Are we truly God's people? Hopefully. And if we're not completely there yet this morning, let us be open to God's help so that in His time, which is much sooner than our own, in His time, we will be gospel people. We will be people.